greeter guy down here wearing this big orange shirt. Well, how's everybody doing? Great.
Ready when you are, CB. Hi, folks. My name is James. From the Hollywood of the 1930s, right on up to the top films of today. And here is some of Hollywood's best. It's a Busby Berkeley musical extravaganza from Footlight Parade. Up ahead, we've got Gene Kelly singing in the rain.
By that dirty, no good, yellow belly stool. I'm supposed to have money, old man. I need a head the first time I see him.
Go right ahead if that's what you're inclined to do. A long time ago, I made me a rule. Let people do what they want. You
know, ladies and gentlemen, please remain seated. Your guide will return momentarily. Remain seated, please.
Yeah, look at here! Just in time for my getaway!
Halt, unbeliever.
Introducing the Disney Girls here at the Theater of the Stars.
Thank you. Salute to Hollywood, starring Mickey and all of the Disney characters.
And if you look off to your right and up into the sky, you'll catch an eyeful of our award-winning Earful Tower. And this is where we house the production teams that we're currently working with here at the studio. For example, Bungalow Number 3 is home to the Mickey Mouse Club, which can be seen weekdays at 5:30 on the Disney Channel. This really is considered one of our fastest growing departments. I guess it's because they're always branching out all over the studio. Inside costuming, you'll see some of the original costumes worn by such stars as Bette Midler in Big Business. Now Disney has over 100 talented artists who design and create costumes for our motion picture, television, and live entertainment needs. And with well over 2.25 million garments, Walt Disney World has the largest working wardrobe anywhere in the world. Michael Jackson's costume from Captain EO. He's the tall one. And some of the costumes of the co-stars of Who Framed Roger Rabbit. A beyond costuming, you'll see our lighting, small props, and our camera departments. This is where we store and maintain these items and this equipment. And Tony and News crews will borrow some of our equipment. You'll also get an inside look at our scenic shop. Something I forgot to mention, as we left the shuttle station, we left in such a hurry. Feel free to take as many photographs and videotape as much as you like along the tour.
This house.
Unless we run into a production crew that's actually filming or taping. We've just entered our own residential street. Billy lives here on Residential Street. Nobody except Herbie the Love Bug. There he sits. He has currently retired himself outside of Vern's house from Ernest Saves Christmas. I thought stone picture. Exterior shots for the Golden Girls show right there. One of the many exterior shots done right here in our studio backlot. Now the interiors for the show are done on a soundstage area out in Burbank, California. And the show itself takes place in Miami. It's all kind of confusing, but it all comes together. Those hanging plants, the toys in the front yard make that final camera shot much more realistic. They say that this side could fit the small country town role, something you might see in Mayberry. But as we turn the corner, take a look at the front side, completely different, it fits the big city role. Now one of the ways in which a lot of change occurs is right beside us, on your right-hand side. We're passing by one of our boneyards. This is where we store some large-scale props and set pieces after they've been used in a production. Take, for instance, this brown leather keelboat that you see. That was last used in 1976 in a Disney production, The Treasures of Matacumbe. Starred Peter Ustinov, and portions of it were shot right here on our own Bay Lake.
portion of the tour, you'll get a glimpse of special effects, editing, sounds, all important components of the enormous effort that goes into it. It really is amazing how many areas of expertise it takes to bring 2 hours of entertainment to the screen.
Hi, Goldie. Hi, Paul. Spring Moran.
Good. What are you doing in the car? You're supposed to be helping each other folks around.
I thought you might want to drive. Hop in.
No, I don't want to drive.
Because the walls are padded, that area doesn't look very large when we fit 160 kids down there.